I do for you, boss?
You seem really, and I do mean really, different from most people.
Scorched or the ferals don't get you. Rads will.
Cheers, friend.
I haven't hit rock bottom yet. Just you wait.
Thank you.
Attention, citizens. Nuclear strike imminent. Please exit the area at your earliest convenience. Thank you for your cooperation.
Field report, Maria Chavez speaking. Being here at AVR Medical really brings back memories. My mother worked at this place for years as a nurse. When I was a child, back before the war, I got sick for days. Supply shortages had driven the price of medicine beyond what we could afford. Lucky for us, my mom wasn't just a nurse, but also a natural green thumb. We had a garden with all kinds of herbs and flowers. She treated me with homemade herbal remedies. Today, disease is rampant. There are countless viruses and bacterial infections out there, and we need a way to deal with them. I was hoping I might find something here to help treat all the sick and injured refugees we've got back at the airport, but unfortunately, the place has been picked pretty clean by now, and there isn't much left. So, having had basically no luck in this creepy abandoned hospital, I decided to turn instead to my mother's wisdom. I put together some herbal tea recipes that should mitigate the symptoms of the more common sicknesses. It's not a cure, but it's something. Okay, well, I think I'll wrap this up. Guess I'm off to pick some flowers.
Thank you. Oh, folks at Foundation doing? If I wasn't so busy,
nice to see you. You know where to find me.
Sometimes I just check out.
Heard you were out there giving us a hand. Hope you got some good news about those patient records.
There's a lot of supplies here that look ripe for the picking.
These records are going to save so many lives. I'll let Ricker know you came through for us. Best of luck out there. Thank you.
Hey there. Don't think we met. I'm Skippy, Skippy Rorich. Something I or the Union can do for you? The Union is a sort of a... I guess you might call us a confederation or a resistance. People banding together for defense. See, there's a group in the pit. Calls themselves fanatics. All they care about is conquest. They want the whole pit for themselves. They roll into your area. You either join them, they force you to labor for them, or they kill you. And they're coming for everybody. The Union's the only thing standing between them and their total conquest of the pit. As much as we're able, anyway. What's a Skippy look like, huh? Call me Skip if you like that better, or whatever you want. Just don't call me Mr. Rorich. Never felt right that. Took me weeks to get that Orlando character to stop doing it, at least my face. That's right, looking for someone to help us take the fight to the fanatics. Surprised we got a taker, actually. You are interested, right? Hell, you've got raider gangs here, right? I've heard about your Blood Eagles. The fanatics are something like them, but more organized. Imagine every single raider gang you've ever heard got together and decided to make like Genghis Khan. Sweep over everything. Kill anyone who won't join. And put anyone too weak to fight into forced labor camps. Everything that's not theirs they take. That's the fanatics. And be glad they're not here. Bad. Don't get me wrong, it's home, and I want us to keep it. But we got hit bad in the war, and we've never recovered. Lots of radiation. Some areas are badly toxic, with all the junk that got blasted into the air is spread around from the factories. People are sick a lot, from one thing or another, and food can be hard to come by. Hell, some of the city's still on fire, I think. But some of the factories survived, and we got them running. Gives us access to things you can't get anywhere else. Might even be able to rebuild. If it weren't for the fanatics. Because it's home, dammit. Mine, ours, all of us who were born and lived there before and after the bombs. Ain't that enough? If the fanatics are out of the picture, we can rebuild. Make something out of it again. It doesn't have to stay like it is. If that ain't enough for you, picture this. A horde of fanatics, hundreds, thousands strong, setting their sights here. Sound like something you want? The Union's back's against the wall. We're doing our best to hold off the fanatics. Keep them from taking everything. Occasionally, we win some small victories, but not a lot. Got a couple of situations back there right now where an extra hand might tip things in our favor, at least for now. I don't want to call it mercenary work, but I'm not gonna lie. You'll be going there to fight. Fantastic. Let me just get Rucker in here. It's her bird, after all. Thanks for coming by, Rucker. Looks like we got a volunteer to take a trip out to the pit.
We've met. Had a feeling you might be up for this when you came by earlier. Guess I was right.
Figured you should be involved, if we're gonna borrow your plane.
Don't let Lennox hear you call it a plane. She takes it personally. Anyway, sure thing. I guess you've already got all the ultra cells you need. I know you've got mine. Sophie and Esme tell me you helped them out too, so I expect you got theirs as well.
Well, we got two different locals I know are in need of help. Locals are what we call union groups that act independently. Local 42's in the industrial district. Hex, their leader, is struggling to keep her people alive and retake a foundry from the fanatics. We got another over in the trench working against a fanatic forced labor camp. Danilo is your contact there. Haven't heard from the other locals recently, but I'm sure we'll be hearing from them if they got trouble too. It's up to you who you want to help right now. Maybe you'll consider going back again later for the other. No can do, Sporia. I'll go back one day, but right now, I'm more use here, rustling up support to send back there. I'm not young enough to be much use on the front lines anymore. Fair enough. What do you want to know? Well,
I can answer that, Skippy. First of all, we've got refugees here from the pit. People who've made it all the way down on footer and caravans. And the best way to help that situation is to help people not need to flee the pit in the first place. Second, the Union's the best chance of stability the pit's got. The responders don't just want a triage in the world. We want to help it rebuild one day. We'll need allies to do that.
It doesn't hurt that we've got factories that can still make manufactured goods either.
No, it does not.
I prefer volunteers to suckers. I'm not running some kind of scam here.
The answer is no, by the way. We run some regular sorties, trade some supplies, carry messages. Our radios don't reach that far, so communications either us or waiting for caravans.
All right. Great. This means a lot to the Union. I'll make sure you're well rewarded for it. I might have some other things I need help with here in Appalachia, too. I'll let you know. Good luck up there. We're counting on you.
Oof. Don't need a Geiger counter when you're glowing like a Christmas tree.
Thank you.